historically, mentoring was not seen as an essential part because it's like that the tough guys and tough girls, they have to solve their job without mentoring. And it was even seen like a weakness if you have a mentor. But actually, I think times have changed. Building the network is extremely important part of the successful MBA program. I mean, nobody should come to MBA just to have a stamp that now I have an MBA something. I think it's bullshit, this kind of thing only. It's nice to have, but still the key is, what do you learn? You should not work for the diploma. You should work for building the network and really learn from others. I would call it, we need a full body contact. And this MBA is a great full body contact opportunity. I mean that the team up first of all between each other from the day one, not after 1 year, but from the day one. And then when there is an international collaboration between international teachers, international, you do trips and so forth, it's heavy work. There is no magical trick on this. That's definitely important. For example, for me, it took years to make an environment where, let's say, 10 of my key people in my company are non-Finns. Because it's always easier to speak in Finnish. We have the same jokes. We drink same drinks. We have in the same Chornaya Banya. Everything is the same. It's easier. But from the leadership standpoint, from the business growth standpoint, it sucks. So we have to learn. I mean, there is no other option. And you have to be interested of people. If you're not interested about people, forget it. You have to be active to get something really valuable for you. And if you do so, you as a leader will grow and your value as a leader will grow. I hope that there would be lawyers, business people, engineers, a little bit older, a little bit younger, perhaps somebody who has a totally different background, perhaps from the art, who has also interest to the business side. Because if everybody is the same, there is no learning.